Jom ni kita bawa Audi Quattro. Lama punya. Yang aku dapat daripada Ban Fine. Baru jadi store. So hari ni aku nak buat Top Gear punya challenge. Jom kita pergi. Turn right. Kereka lah pula.
In 200 yards, turn left. Turn left. At your destination.
Jom kita teruskan next chapter. Apa dia suka dia buat lah ni?
This is Project EAT. That's EAT for E-Class All Terrain. It's a modified Merc built by the Top Gear magazine team for finding bears in the woods. Not many bears around here though, mostly badgers. Still, there's definitely some terrain, lots of it. All you need is a good sense of direction, or not. Here's Stig again, looking lost. Terrified of maps, apparently. Inner compass points directly south. The EAT has a silky smooth V6 diesel. It'll do 155 miles an hour on the road, but where we're going, we won't need roads. First up, it's a trip to the top of Glen Rannoch, by any means necessary, and against the clock, naturally. But don't worry, it has knobbly tyres, and a roof rack for carrying extra knobbly tyres.
In 400 yards, turn left.
Ohoy, the sliding. Sliding.
That's a four-wheel drive car on mud tires completely sideways. You'd do well in rallying with skills like that. Top draw drifting, I reckon. Who says you need an SUV to go off-road? The EAT has four-wheel drive and air suspension to smooth out lumps and bumps and everyday obstacles. Ancient burial mounds, for example. Kaling dia punya buting ni.
Turn sharp left. Oh. 200 yards. Turn right. Turn right. In 200 yards, turn left. Left. In 400 yards, turn sharp left. Turn sharp left.
It also has 340 horsepower, more torque than a cruise ship, and gets to 60 miles an hour in just over 5 seconds.
Turn right.
Now it's time to head way over there, to the very top of Arthur's Seat. But first, what goes up must come down.
My eye.
Yards. Turn left.
Ah, I have to go down again.
lady's wagon, so it's tough. And if you really want to smash stuff up, there's even a pickaxe in the back. It's full of home comforts, the EAT. Charges for almost anything you can charge. Cozy ambient lighting, even a portable espresso machine. Everything the intrepid explorer can ever need. The EAT has a silky smooth V6 diesel. It'll do 155 miles an hour on the road, but where we're going, we won't need roads. First up, it's a trip to the top of Glen Rannoch by any means necessary and against the clock, naturally. But don't worry, it has knobbly tyres and a roof rack for carrying extra knobbly tyres.
In 400 yards, turn left. Turn left.
On mud tyres, completely sideways. You'd do well in rallying with skills like that. Top draw drifting, I reckon. Who says you need an SUV to go off-road? The EAT has four-wheel drive and air suspension to smooth out lumps and bumps and everyday obstacles. Ancient burial mounds, for example.
Aduh.
Just over 5 seconds. Up must come down. some proper hang time. Actual air suspension.
In 400 yards, turn left. Turn around when it is safe to do so. In 200 yards, turn left. Turn left.
Charges for almost anything you can charge. Cozy ambient lighting, even a portable espresso machine. Everything the intrepid explorer can ever need.
At the roundabout, take the first exit. Yards, turn right. Turn right.
All right. All this adventure kit's had a tiny effect on the fuel efficiency. Good job the roof rack holds two cans of diesel, and there's another one in the back. Just don't confuse it with your drinking water. Now, just the small matter of getting up Arthur's seat. The clock's ticking, so better step on it, Stiggy.
In 200 yards, turn left.
Arthur's seat. No idea who Arthur is, by the way, or why his seat's so big. Nice view, though. Shame there's no time to stick around.